Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett, and today we're going to look at the PKG command in Solaris 11 and how we can work with our boot environments with the command PKG. As always, you can find these videos on theurbanpenguin.com. If you're on Twitter, you can follow me at theurbanpenguin. And on Facebook, you'll be able to find and like my page, again, as The Urban Penguin. So we're just working on the console of my Oracle Solaris 11 machine, and we're just going to gain some root privileges so we can use sudo and start up a bash shell, or whatever you would prefer. Obviously, we could use sudo and just run the commands directly, or use su for substitute a user to gain our root privileges. The PKG command works with our imaging packaging system and can allow us easily to list what's installed, and we can see here with PKG list we can see everything that is installed. If we wanted to search for something in particular, we could use something like PKG list and the package name. If we were uncertain of the package name, we could just go and use something like grep to search, in this case, for GCC. We see we've got the runtime environment, but we don't have the full GCC package installed. We've got a set of commands like install, uninstall, update, and if we install just the package GCC-3, then we will see that it installs three packages, not just the one package. And of course, I don't need to know the package location. It's going to be located within my environment. We also see that there's these options to create boot environments or backup boot environments. Once installed, of course, if I do want to uninstall it, I can use the uninstall command. And you'll see why in a moment. We'll just play around a little bit with GCC. But again, I don't need to know anything other than the package name to be able to uninstall it. In this case, it's only taking the one package off, so it's leaving the two additional packages that were dependencies on GCC that it's left install. So I'd have to, if I wanted to clean up the environment totally, remove those. And that's where your backup and your boot environment might come in handy. Or if we're looking at updating the kernel or something like that, we can provide a safe way of manipulating this. If we go through and look at the help with our install, and this will be the same for our uninstall and our updates, we've got these options, as we saw before, to create backup and BE environments. If I go through and install now GCC, so we're just going back PKG install, but I'm going to use the option minus minus BE hyphen name, so we're going to create a backup environment. The install of the package that we specify is going to be installed into the boot environment that we're calling, in this case, GCC. So we're installing the package GCC3 into a new boot environment. The boot environment will be active on the new next boot. But it means that I've got this separate snapshot that I can boot up into. I can test it before I install it, if you like, in my full production environment. So the installation appears to be going ahead, and of course it is going ahead, but not into our current environment. It's being installed into a different snapshot of Solaris. So we can see we've cloned the current environment and created a new boot environment called GCC. It will be activated on the next reboot, but as long as I'm there, I can control the reboot process. If I go through and have a look at the command BEADM, so our boot environment administration, we can see now we have two boot environments, Solaris, our original one, and that's the current environment marked by the N. GCC is marked with the R, which means it will be available on the next reboot. So all it means is it's the default for the next reboot. So obviously I could change back up to my Oracle Solaris 11.1, but I'll go ahead and boot into GCC, and we'll allow the system to boot, and we should see that this has got the full GCC3 package that we installed. So as we allow the system to boot and we log on, and then we gain our root privileges, we can run our PKG list command, and we can see that GCC3 is fully installed in this environment. I could now carry out tests and make sure all my other software was working before we run it in our main environment. Obviously, I can't be running both environments at the same time, but we've provided a safe mechanism in which to install, update, or remove a package. I can't remove or do anything with this boot environment whilst I'm boot up to it. If we look at the BE admin and list at the moment, we can see that GCC is the current one marked by the N and will be ready on the next reboot. But if I mark Solaris as the active one, then Solaris will be the default in the grub menu for the next boot. And then if I decide that I no longer want GCC installed, all I have to do is delete this boot environment. So on the reboot now, again allowing the reboot to go through, logging on and gaining root privileges, I can remove the previous environment GCC with BEA admin, destroy GCC. That's just the boot environment name, and I can't destroy it obviously whilst I'm booted up to that environment. So of course we're still in the situation where GCC is not installed. So if we go through and double check for that, we can see we've just got the runtime environment within our Solaris boot environment. And we'll take a look now at the backup BE environment. So we'll run the install again, but this time we're going to use the option --backup-BE name. This means any packaging operation that we do will be in our current environment, but we'll clone our current environment to the backup name. So if we do need to revert, we can revert to our clone. So we're creating a clone now called no GCC to indicate that it doesn't have GCC installed. Creating the backup boot environment means that we're actually installing GCC3 now into our current environment. Our clone is left with it not installed. And I say we could use this for any of our packaging operations. So whether this is an update and we want to test the update, or whether we're doing an uninstall, or as in this case, an install. But with the backup BE name option, we're installing into our current environment. The clone then is without the operation being completed. So if we look at BE admin list, we've not changed our boot environment other than creating the boot environment. Solaris is still the active and current environment. If we go through and check with our packaging command, we can see now we have installed GCC3, but if we went into no GCC, it wouldn't have GCC. So thank you, and I look forward to seeing you again soon.